Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing a book review. So as you know guys, for those who know me personally, I'm a very avid book reader. I read a lot of books, you know, all the time. I like to, you know, fill up my mind with good information and learn a lot from different perspectives, different people. And I advise you to do the same. So today we're going to be doing a review of one of my favorite books. So this book is called Shoe Dog. For those who don't know it, for those who know it, then hey, shout out to you. This is a book by Phil Knight. This is the creator of Nike, or the founder of Nike. And it's all about, you know, how he founded Nike, some challenges he faced, you know, and there's a lot of valuable business lessons that I learned from this book, and I want to share them with you. So lesson number one I learned from Shoe Dog: belief is irresistible. So don't sell your product to your customer, sell your customer to your product. Meaning that show your customer that you believe so much in your product, and I mean they'll believe in you. But if you don't believe in your product, then it doesn't work. So this has been sort of a universal advice for people in sales, for people, business owners, because I mean sales skews your business. But everybody else who's selling whatever they're selling, if you don't believe in what you're selling, then your customer don't have to buy it from you. And then lesson number two that I learned from the Shoe Dog is competition. You know, go all out and bust your gut. And if somebody still beats you, you must make that person use everything he has and more. You know what I mean? And prove to be better than you. So what I got from this was that when you have competition, you must be the hardest working person in the room. That whoever's going to be beating you must be working twice as hard as you on that day. You know what I mean? So which makes, you know, the best at what you do. That's if you want to be the best at what you do. And I'm pretty sure that you don't want to be the best at what you do. You want to be one of the last people, you know, at the bottom of the, you know, pyramid who's doing whatever you do in your industry or anything else that you want to do in life. So if you want to build a company like Nike, that's what the key is. Competition, you know, you must make your competition work as hard as they can, or two times harder than you at that day or at that moment they beat you. Even if it's by just 2 seconds, you know what I mean? They must work three times harder than you. Okay, number three is quite of a cliche, is trust your gut. You know, there's a lot of instances in this book that shows that your gut is much more right most of the time. Trust your gut. So always trust your gut. Like, for example, when he was negotiating his deal with the Japanese guy, the Kitami, his supplies, and he says that they were gonna rip him off, and he managed to start making, you know, obviously his second and third options after that. So that was something also that he followed his gut, and it was right at that point, and it helped him save his business. Or if he didn't take that action at that time, I mean, he was gonna lose his business. I mean, even yourself, a lot of times when you feel like something is not right, how many times have you ignored that feeling and you actually find out that it's not even right, actually, and you were right before, and you regret it, you know? So trusting your gut really helps, and I mean, a lot of kids trust their guts. I think as we grow up, we get to lose it because of society and where we grow up, and a lot of other influences that we get from outside. So trusting your gut might sound as cliche as possible, but it's key to your success. Okay, lesson number four that I learned is that know who you are doing business with. So it's much more better to do a little bit of a background. You know what I mean? As you see, you know, Mr. Knight or Phil Knight, you know, growing his business, he started doing a little bit of a homework who he's doing business with, and obviously the sort of relationships that they're looking for, and being very upfront about what he's looking to get out of the business deal instead of just leaving it open-ended. You know what I mean? So everybody knows what they're expecting, and they understand the expectations of all the teams, and if they're happy with that, they move forward with a good partnership or marriage in business. So number five is surrounding yourself with people smarter than you. So what I picked up from also Phil Knight is that a lot of people that he had on his team were way, way smarter than him. You know, not that he was not smart, but the guys knew what they were doing. Like, they were terrific at what they did, and they were the best, you know. And he had a thing of picking guys who were the best people to do it, from his partner, Mr. Bowman, to, you know, Strasser, to all the lawyers that he had on his executive team, to all his teammates. It was very, very smart people around him. Okay, lesson number six is fail fast and fail often and improve. So it's much better to start something, test it out, try it, and fail, you know? and fail often, fail a lot of times and improve. And also, you know what I mean? One thing he also mentioned is that when you fail, you know, don't be scared of giving up and trying something else. You know what I mean? Not that you must give up on your dream, but you must give up on something that doesn't work and try something else that works. You know what I mean? You must give up, but never stop trying. So when something doesn't work and you try it, it's not working out, you must not be scared of starting over, scratching it, going back to the drawing board and starting over again. So that's something also I learned from this, and I think it's a valuable lesson for entrepreneurs. Okay, number 7, there is power in being the first, you know? So the first, I mean, even in races, if you are the first person, you get the gold medal. So the first, everything always has power. And as you can see, in their case, they were the first shoe maker to be allowed to do business in China, you know, after 25 years, you know, and they actually benefited from a lot of that because they got some factories first, a lot of, you know, better treatment from the Chinese government, and a lot of other incentives that came on after that. So being the first person to do something actually helps you do a lot of stuff and also get you your foot in the door. So it actually helps a lot to be the first person to do something. I think I'm losing my train of thought there, but the key is just being the first to do something really, really helps, and it's something that, you know, you want to be in life at some point. And then number 8 is the coward never started, the weak died along the way, and that leaves the brave. I mean, that's self-explanatory. So meaning that cowards, you know, they thinkers, man. They're just sitting down thinking about, I want to do this, I want to do that, 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 and they never do anything. You know what I mean? So they never actually started anything. They just have all these ideas in their head, and they never did nothing. And then the weak died along the way, because, I mean, the weak, I mean, the brave men are going to persist and persist and persist and never stop. But the weak men, they're not going to go all out when they do their stuff. They're going to go all in until things get tough. They die along the way. So that's the lesson in there, is that don't be the weak and don't be the coward. Get started, try things out, and have the persistence, and never stop. Never stop, keep trying and keep trying and keep trying. And I think number 9 is that business is about helping others improve their lives while you're helping yourself improve your life. You know what I mean? Or your team's life, or you, every people around you, or whoever you're building business with. So that is all of what it's all about, you know. It's not just about the money. The money comes from you helping somebody else improve their lives or live their life to the fullest. So that's another lesson I learned from this book, and I think is very, very key to entrepreneurs to learn that as a principle. And then number 10, take a chance on people, man. You know, tell people what to do. That's what he says here. I'm just quoting what he says. He says, tell people what to do. Don't show them what to do. Let them surprise you. You know what I mean? Don't be the guy who's too much into the details, unless if they're deviating from what they have to do. But just tell them what to do and let them figure out a way to do it, which is much better, because you're giving people a chance, you're giving people a freedom to do what they're best at. So those are the 10 lessons that I learned from reading Shoe Dog. So I want you to, you know, comment below if you read Shoe Dog and what lessons you learned that I have missed in my video. And also, you can just comment and let me know which one of the lessons you think were the most valuable for entrepreneurs to learn when they're starting, when they're scaling, and when they're building their businesses. So please comment below, and thank you for watching this video. See you on the next one.